Hello everyone, this is Neetu from St. Paul School. I welcome you all in this class. Today I will teach you chapter 9 from Footprints Without Feet textbook. Chapter name is Boli. Boli, actually that is the name of a girl and her real name is Sulekha. But because of some problem, she was not a normal child. Because when she was in her childhood, something happened. When she fall down from her bed, her brain system damaged from internally. So she was not just like a normal child. So all the people were calling by Boli, not by her real name. And her father was a nambardar, because he was collecting the revenue. And he was a very rich person. So in the short summarized points, we can say like that in this chapter we will study about her earlier days, it means her formative years. Later then, when Boli begins schooling, when she sent to the school. Then Boli gets ready for school. Later then we will study Boli's first day at school, when she went to the school first time, how she reacted to the teachers and with her classmates. Later then we will study how Boli's village changes. It means we all know that in our ancient time, there were not all the facilities like that at the present time we had. Actually this chapter related to just like a very ancient time, because nowadays all the people send their girl child also to the school. But in this story we will study like that, that time parents were not sending their girl child to the school, only they were sending to their son. Later then Boli's father settled her marriage with a very aged man, just like her father says. When Boli was just 8 or 10 years old, that time he fixed her marriage, and that her groom was something 45 years. Later then how Boli stand up for her rights. So now I am starting the chapter. With this explanation I will tell you difficult word meaning also. Her name was Sulekha. But since her childhood, everyone had been calling her Boli, the simpleton. Simpleton, we can say ordinary, means simply they were calling by this name Boli, because she was, in Hindi we can say Boli Bhali Ladki. So they were calling by this Boli. She was the fourth daughter of Nambardar Ramlal. Ramlal was the name of her father and he was the Nambardar. When she was 10 months old, she had fallen off the cot, cot means bed, on her head. And perhaps it had damaged some part of her brain. So when she was only 10 months old, that time she fell down off the cot on her head. Sir ke bal gir gayi thi bed se. So that time her brain part damaged. That was why she remained a backward. Backward means comparatively back. She was not developing just like a normal child and came to be known as Boli the simpleton. At birth, the child was very fair and pretty. But when she was 2 years old, she had an attack of smallpox. Only the eyes were saved, but the entire body was permanently disfigured. When she was 2 years old, that time she was affected by the smallpox. Smallpox, we all know, in that on her body there were many pokes, bahut nishan ban gaye se, and permanently uske body pe only the eyes were saved. So permanently disfigured. So her body became disfigured. disfigured, we can say spoiled her figure, because by this smallpox her figure completely spoiled by deep black pock marks on her face, on her body. There were a black color pock marks. Little Sulekha could not speak till she was 5, and when she was 5 years old, that time she was not able to speak fluently, and when at last she learned to speak, she stammered means haklana, stuttering. When she at last she learned how to speak, but she was just stammering, stuttering. The other children often made fun at her. So all the other children always laugh at her when she was just stammering, and they mimicked her. They were copying her voice. As a result, she talked very little. So all the people, all the children were laughing at her. So what she decided? She decided that she remained always silent, because she knew about it. If she will speak anything, all the children copied her and they will make fun at her. She talked very little. Ramlal had 7 children, 3 sons and 4 daughters. Her father had total 7 children, 3 sons and 4 daughters. And the youngest of them was Bholi, and the youngest, sabse choti Bholi. It was a prosperous farmer's household, and there was a plenty to eat and drink. It means he was, as we know that Ramlal was a rich person. There was a plenty to eat and drink. All the children except Bholi were healthy and strong. Only Bholi was very weak, and she was not as strong as her other siblings. The sons had been sent to the city to study in schools and later in colleges. Ramlal, he had 3 sons, so he was sending his sons to schools and later then in colleges. Because in ancient time, people were sending only the boy child to the school. So people were providing education to only the son, not girls. Of the daughters, Radha, the eldest was Radha in girl child, had already been married. Radha ki already marriage ho chuki thi. The second daughter, Mangla's marriage had also been settled. Uski bhi fix thi marriage, and when that was done, Ramlal would think of the third, Champa. And Ramlal had already decided when Mangla's marriage happened, that time he will decide marriage of Champa also. Champa was the third girl child, and the last one was the Bholi. They were good looking, but all the three were good looking. They were smart, good looking, healthy girls. They all three means that Radha, Mangla and Champa. They were smart and good looking and healthy also, and it was not difficult to find bridegrooms for them. But Ramlal was worried about Bholi. She had neither good looks nor intelligence. But only Ramlal was worried about Bholi, because she was not good looking, she was not intelligent also, and she was just stammering also. She cannot speak fluently. Bholi was 7 years old when Mangla was married. And when Ramlal's second girl child got married, that time Bholi was only 7 years old. The same year, a primary school for girls was opened in their village. The Tehsildar Sahib came to perform its opening ceremony. So when there were a primary school open, that time Tehsildar Sahib came to perform its opening ceremony. In the inauguration ceremony, Tehsildar came there. He said to Ramlal, "As a revenue official, you are the representative." Representative means you are the person to speak on the behalf of the ceremony. Representative means we can say a person appointed to act or speak on behalf of others. In Hindi we can say pratinidhi of the government in the village, and so you must set an example to the villagers. You must send your daughters to school. So Tehsildar said to this Ramlal that you have to send your daughters to in school, so all the people will inspire you and they will also send their child to the school. That night when Ramlal consulted his wife, she cried, "Are you crazy?" So when Ramlal shared this all things with his wife, she shouted, "Are you crazy?" Crazy means mad. Tum pagal ho gaye ho. If girls go to school, who will marry them? If we will send girls to the school, then who will marry them? But Ramlal had not the courage to disobey the tehsildar. But Ramlal ke andar itna courage nahi tha ki wo disobey kar sake tehsildar, because it was the order from a tehsildar. At last his wife said, "I will tell you what to do. Send Bholi to school. As it is, there is a little chance of her getting married with her ugly face and lack of sense. Let the teachers at school worry about her." So Ramlal's wife decided that, okay, we will send Bholi to the school. So all the teachers also, they will be worried about Bholi, because we already know that it's very difficult to find a bridegroom for her. The next day, Ramlal caught Bholi by the hand and said, "Come with me, I'll take you to school." Bholi was frightened. She was afraid. She was feeling very fear, because she didn't know about it, that what is a school. Even that time, Ramlal was telling to him that, "I will take you to school." But she was not familiar with this word, school. So she was frightened. She did not know what a school was like. She remembered how a few days ago their old cow Lakshmi had been turned out of the house and sold. Because she didn't know about school, but earlier when she remembered how a few days ago their old cow Lakshmi had turned out of the house and sold. उसे ये पता था थोड़े दिन के पहले उनकी एक गाय थी लक्ष्मी, जिसे इस घर से बाहर बेच दिया गया था, उसे बेचा गया था. So she was thinking just like the same, that I am also sending out by my house and maybe they are selling to me. No. She shouted in terror and pulled her hand away from her father's grip. "What's the matter with you, you fool?" shouted Ramlal. And suddenly Ramlal started to shout, "Are you fool? I am only taking you to school." Then he told his wife, "Let her wear some decent clothes today, or else what will the teachers and the other school girls think of us when they see at her?" So later then Ramlal, when he saw at the appearance of a Bholi, then he told to his wife that, "Just put some nice clothes on her body, because if we will send her like this, then what the teachers will think about us and what the school girl think about us." Because he was worried about his identity. New clothes had never been made for Bholi, because before that day Bholi never got the new dresses. She always got the old dresses of her elder sisters. The old dresses of her sisters were passed on her. No one cared to mend or wash her clothes. But today, she was lucky to receive a clean dress which had shrunk after many washings and no longer fitted champa. She was even bath oil was rubbed into her dry and matted hair. Only then did she begin to believe that she was being taken to a place better than her home. When she was decorated by new clothes, her hair's oiled, and then she understood that surely I am going to some better place from my house, better than my house. Because she got new dress also, that day she took bath and her hairs also prepared. When they reached the school, the children were already in their classroom. Ramlal handed over his daughter to the headmistress. Left alone, the poor girl looked about her with fear-laden eyes. There were several rooms, and in each room, girls like her squatted on mats, reading from books or writing on slates. The headmistress asked Bholi to sit down in a corner in one of the classroom. When Bholi reached there, she saw that in each classroom there were girls, and some were reading and some were like her squatted on mats. Some were sitting on their mats, mean chatai pe baithi hui thi. Some were reading and some were writing on slates. The headmistress asked Bholi to sit down in a corner in one of the classroom. Bholi did not know what exactly a school was like and what happened there. But she was glad means happy, to find so many girls almost of her own age present there. But she was happy because there were girls just like her age. She hoped and she was thinking that one of these girls might become her friend. The lady teacher who was in the class was saying something to the girls, but Bholi could understand nothing. But she was not able to understand anything. She looked at the pictures like the horse on the which the tehsildar had come to visit their village. And on that classroom walls there were pictures just like a horse. Then suddenly she started to think like that when the tehsildar came in the inauguration ceremony, that time he came on the horse. So he was comparing, like that time she had seen the horse and now there were the another horse. The goat was black like the goat of their neighbors. The parrot was green like the parrot she had seen in the mango orchard. And the cow was just like their Lakshmi. So she had seen their pictures of horse, goat, cow. And suddenly Bholi noticed that the teacher was just standing by her side, smiling at her. "What's your name, little one?" Then in a very humble way, her teacher asked to her. Then how she replied, "Bho, bho, bho." She could stammer no further than that. And she started to stammering. Then she began to cry and tears flowed from her eyes in a helpless flood. She kept her head down and as she sat in her corner, not daring to look up at the girls whom she knew were still laughing at her. And she sat there silently because all the girls were laughing at her. When the school bell rang, all the girls scurried out of the classroom, but Bholi dared not leave her corner. Her head still lowered. She kept on sobbing. Sobbing means jab hum rote hue chup ho jate hain. That is the sobbing, siska rahi thi. Bholi, the teacher's voice was so soft and soothing. In all her life, she had never been called like that. Because every time at her house, all were shouting at her. No one was talking in this sweet manner, just like as the teacher was talking with her. It touched her heart. So the way of her speaking, it means the way how the teacher was speaking with her, that touched her heart. She was fascinated by the teacher. "Get up," said the teacher. It was not a command, but just a friendly suggestion. Bholi got up. "Now tell me your name." Sweat broke out over her whole body. Would her stammering tongue again disgrace her? For the sake of this kind woman, however, she decided to make an effort. She had such a soothing voice, she would not laugh at her. "Bha, bha, bho, bho, bho," she began to stammer. "Well done, well done," the teacher encouraged her. "Come on, now the full name. Now tell me the full name." See, we all know if we motivated, if we encourage anyone, then surely that the person can do anything. So the same thing teacher was doing with her. "Bha, bha, bho, Bholi." At last she was able to say it and felt relieved as if it was a great achievement. Well done. The teacher patted her affectionately and said, "Put the fear out of your heart and you will be able to speak like everyone else." Then her teacher replied that, "Why you frightened? Put out the fear. Surely one day you will be able to speak just like the others." Bully looked up as if to ask, "Really?" Then she asked, "Really, I will be able to speak just like the others?" "Yes, yes. It will be very easy. You just come to school every day. Will you come?" Bully nodded. Then Bully replied, "Yes." "No, say it loudly." Because that time, उसने इशारा किया था सिर हिला के, ये ये यस. एंड दिस टाइम भोली रिप्लाइड यस. एंड भोली हरसेल्फ वाज एस्टोनिश्ड दैट शी हैड बीन एबल टू से इट. देन शी अंडरस्टूड दैट यस, आई कैन आल्सो स्पीक. डिडंट आई टेल यू? नाउ टेक दिस बुक. द बुक वाज फुल ऑफ नाइस पिक्चर. एंड दैट टाइम टीचर हैड गिवन अ बुक. इट वाज अ फुल ऑफ नाइस पिक्चर्स. द पिक्चर्स वर इन कलर. डॉग, कैट, goat, horse, parrot, tiger and a cow, just like a Lakshmi. And with every picture there was a word in big black letters. "In 1 month you will be able to read this book." And then the teacher replied that, "In 1 month you will be able to read this book. Then I will give you a bigger book, then a still bigger one. In time you will be more learned than anyone else in the village. And after some month you will be just like a learned than anyone else in the village. Because one day, एक दिन तुम बहुत विद्वान हो जाओगी जितना कि इस गांव में कोई भी नहीं है. Then no one will ever be able to laugh at you. People will listen to you with respect and you will be able to speak without the slightest stammer. Understand? Then, so this is the motivation which was given by the teacher to Bhuli. So Bhuli was a feeling very proud and she was a thinking in a positive way as the teacher was telling to her. And she was also thinking that one day I will also not stammering and I will be able to speak just like a other. And they will, that time they will not laugh at me. They will also give me respect. Understand? Now go home and come back early tomorrow morning. Bhuli felt as if suddenly all the bells in Billy's temple were ringing and the trees in front of the schoolhouse had blossomed into big red flowers. Her heart was throbbing with a new hope and a new life. Thus the years passed. The village became a small town. The little primary school became a high school. There were now a cinema under a tin shed and a cotton ginning mill. The mail train began to stop at the railway station. It means time passed, years passed, and now the village developed and all the things that happened there. Now that train also started to stop there. One night after dinner, Ramlal said to his wife, "Then shall I accept Bishambar's proposal?" "Yes, certainly," his wife said. "Bhuli will be lucky to get such a well-to-do bridegroom." And now they were talking about Bhuli's marriage. Because that time they had a Bishambar Nath proposal. And they have decided that now they will accept this. And actually that Bishambar Nath was something 40 to 45 years old, just like Bhuli's father says. Then Bhuli's mother said, "Yes, certainly," his wife said. "Bhuli will be lucky to such a well-to-do bridegroom, a big shop, a house of his own, and I hear several thousands in the bank. Moreover, he is not asking for any dowry, and he is not asking for dowry also." "That's right, but he is not so young, you know." Then Ramlal replied that, "You don't know, he is not so young, almost the same age as I am. And he also limps." Limps means walk with a lameness, langdai, apang. "Moreover, the children from his first wife are quite grown up. उसकी पहली बीवी के बच्चे हैं वो भी काफी वयस्क है। सो वॉट डज इट मैटर, हिज वाइफ रिप्लाइड 45 और 50। देन 5 रिप्लाइड कितना होगा, 45 और 50, इट्स ओके, इट इज नॉट ग्रेट एज फॉर मैन। वी आर लकी दैट ही इज फ्रॉम अनदर विलेज एंड डजेंट नो अबाउट हर पोक मार्क्स एंड वी दैट हर रामलाल्स वाइफ रिप्लाइड दैट वी आर लकी दैट ही इज फ्रॉम द अदर विलेज एंड ही डजेंट नो अबाउट हर पोक मार्क्स। उसकी बॉडी पे जो मार्क है उसके बारे में उसे पता नहीं है, दैट इज द गुड थिंग। हर लैक ऑफ सेंस, इफ यू डोंट एक्सेप्ट दिस प्रपोजल शी मे रिमेन अनमैरिड ऑल हर लाइफ। येस बट आई वंडर वॉट पोली विल से, वॉट विल द विडोल्स वन से, शी इज लाइक अ डम्ब काउ। देन रामलाल्स वाइफ रिप्लाइड दैट शी इज जस्ट लाइक अ डम्ब काउ। मे बी यू आर राइट, मटर रामलाल। इन द वन इन द अदर कॉर्नर ऑफ द कर्ट यार्ड भोली ले अवेक ऑन हर कॉट लिसनिंग टू हर पेरेंट्स विस्पर्ड कन्वर्सेशन। भोली वॉज देयर ऑन हर कॉट ऑन हर बेड एंड शी वॉज अ लिसनिंग साइलेंटली लिसनिंग ऑल द थिंग्स। बिशंबर नाथ वॉज अ वेल टू डू ग्रॉसर, ही केम विद अ बिग पार्टी ऑफ फ्रेंड्स एंड रिलेशंस विद हिम फॉर द वेडिंग एंड दैट डे केम ही कम विथ हर फ्रेंड्स एंड रिलेशंस। अ ब्रास बैंड प्लेइंग अ पॉपुलर टून फ्रॉम एन इंडियन फिल्म हैड इट द प्रोसेशन विद द ब्राइड ग्रूम राइडिंग अ डेकोरेटेड हॉर्स। रामलाल वॉज ओवर जॉय टू सी सच अ पॉम्प विथ अ स्प्लैंडर। He had never dreamt that his fourth daughter would have such a grand wedding. And Ramlal बहुत ज़्यादा खुश था because she never thought like that my fourth daughter like Bholi, she was not a normal. Her sense of humor was also just like a unnormal child. And she is a lucky girl because this type of a grand marriage he had never seen in his life. Bholi's elder sisters who had come for the occasion were envious of her luck. They were feeling jealous. Bholi's three sisters, they were feeling jealous by Bholi's marriage. When the auspicious moment came, the priest said, bring the bride. As we know that the priest हर जगह कहता है दुल्हन को लाइए। सो द सेम थिंग देयर हैपेंड। भोली क्लैड इन अ रेड सिल्कन ब्राइडल ड्रेस वॉज लेड टू द ब्राइड्स प्लेस नियर द सैक्रेड फायर गार्लैंड द ब्राइड। वन ऑफ हिज फ्रेंड्स प्रॉम्प्टेड बिशंबर नाथ स्लिप्ड बैक द सिल्कन वेल, वेल मीन्स पर्दा, घूंघट फ्रॉम द ब्राइड्स फेस। एंड सडनली भोली के चेहरे से जो वेल था, घूंघट था, थोड़ा सा हट गया। बिशंबर्स took a quick glance and that time as will replaced Bishambar saw that pock marks on the Bholi's face. The garland remained poised in his hand. The bride slowly pulled down the veil over her face. Have you seen her? Said Bishambar to the friend next to him. So there were Bishambar's friend standing just near of him. Then the Bishambar asked to him, have you seen? So what? You are not young either. So his friend replied that you are also not young, na? Maybe, but if I am to marry her, her father must give me 5,000 rupees. Then Bishambar Nath replied that so what if I am not young? This is not a matter, but if I'll marry girl like that, her father has to give me 5,000 rupees. No, 5,000. Maybe, but if I am to marry her, her father must give me 5,000 rupees. Ramlal went and placed his turban, his honor, at Bishambar's feet. Do not humiliate me so. Take 2,000 rupees. And Bholi's father requested to Bishambar Nath that I can give you 2,000 rupees. Please don't humiliate. No, 5,000 or we go back. Keep your daughter. Be a little considerate, please. If you go back, I can never show my face in the village. Then out with 5,000. Then Bishambharnath replied that then bring 5,000 rupees. Tears streaming down his face, Ramlal went in, opened the safe and counted out with the notes. He placed the bundle at the bridegroom's feet. And finally, he brought 5,000 rupees for Bishambharnath. On Bishambhar's greedy face appeared triumphant smile. Vijayi Muskan. Triumphant. Triumph means success. He had gambled and won. Give me the garland, he announced. And later then, as he received 5,000, as he got 5,000 rupees, he announced, give me the garland. Once again, the veil was slipped back from the bride's face. But this time, her eyes were not downcast. Again, one more time, veil ghungat uske chehre se hata. But this time, her eyes were not downcast. She was looking up, looking straight at her prospective husband. But this time she was not looking downside. She was looking at her prospective husband. And in her eyes there were neither anger nor hate, only cold contempt. Bishambhar raised the garland to place it round the bride's neck. But before he could do so, Bholi's hand struck out like a streak of lightning and the garland was flung into the fire. She got up and threw away the veil. And suddenly she threw the veil. Usne apne chehre se ghungat hata diya. Aur jo Bishambhar ke haath mein mala thi, wo bhi aag mein jaake gir gayi. Pitaji, said Bholi in a clear, loud voice. And her father, mother, sisters, brothers, relations and neighbors were startled to hear speak without even the slightest stammer. And they were shocked because this time she was not stammering. She was just speaking very clearly and very fluently. Pitaji, take back your money. I am not going to marry this man. Then Bholi replied that, Pitaji, you take your money because now I am not going to marry with this greedy man, Bishambharnath. Ramlal was thunderstruck. Thunderstruck means shocked. The guest began to whisper, so you shameless, so shameless, so ugly, so shameless. Bholi, are you crazy? Shouted Ramlal. And suddenly Ramlal started shouting, are you crazy? Are you mad, Bholi? You want to disgrace your family? Have you some regard for our Ijjat? Then Bholi replied, for the sake of your Ijjat, said Bholi, I was willing to marry this lamb old man. Bholi ne kaha, मैं आपकी इज्जत के लिए ही इस लैम इस लंगड़े आदमी से शादी करी थी. बट आई विल नॉट हैव सच अ मीन ग्रीडी एंड कॉन्टेम्प्टेबल कावर्ड एज माय हस्बैंड. आई वोंट. व्हाट अ शेमलेस गर्ल, वी ऑल थॉट शी वाज अ हार्मलेस डंब काउ. भोली टर्न्ड वायलेंटली ऑन द ओल्ड वुमन. वन ओल्ड वुमन वॉज देयर एंड शी वॉज अ speaking like that. We were thinking like that she is just like a dumb cow, but no, she is so shameless. How she was speaking in front of all the relatives. Then Bholi replied, turned violently, and yes auntie, you are right. Then she replied, yes auntie, you are right. You all thought I was a dumb driving cow, that's why you wanted to hand me over to this heartless creature. आप लोगों को क्या लग रहा था, मैं एक बिना बोलने वाली जानवर हूँ, इसलिए आप मुझे इस जानवर को सौंप रहे थे जिसके अंदर हार्ट ही नहीं है. ही वॉज सच अ क्रूअल पर्सन. बट नाउ द डम्ब काउ द स्टैमरिंग फुल इज स्पीकिंग. डू यू वॉन्ट टू हियर सम मोर. देन भोली रिप्लाइड, क्या आप लोग कुछ और सुनना चाहते हैं. डू यू वॉन्ट टू हियर मोर. बिशंबर नाथ the grocer started to go back with his party. The confused benchman thought that this was the end of the ceremony and struck of a closing song. The benchmen were confused. They were thinking like that now the marriage is over. So they were started to the closing song. Ramlal stood rooted to the ground, his head bowed low with the weight of grief and shame. The flames of the sacred fire slowly died down. Everyone was gone. Ramlal turned to Bholi and said, "But what about you? No one will ever marry you now. What shall we do with you?" And Sulekha said in a voice that was calm and steady. Then Sulekha means Bholi replied, very soft and sweet voice, "Don't you worry, Pitaji. In your old age, I will serve you and mother. I will teach in the same school where I learned so much. Don't worry, Pitaji. In your old age, I will serve you. I will take care both of you, my father and mother. I will take care and I will teach in the same school where I learned all the things. Is not that right, ma'am?" Because her teacher was also there. And she was watching all the, just like a drama, and she was listening how her student representing herself. And that time, Bholi's teacher was feeling very proud, because we all know when a painter paints his or her masterpiece and how they feel. The same feeling that time Bholi's teacher had. Then the teacher had all along stood in a corner watching the drama. "Yes, Bholi," she replied. "Yes, Bholi, of course," she replied, and in her smiling eyes was the light of a deep satisfaction. Now that time Bholi's teacher was completely satisfied that an artist feels when contemplating the completion of her masterpiece, because this was the masterpiece work of that Bholi's teacher, and she was feeling very proud on Bholi. So with this, the chapter is over. I hope you understand this. If you have any query, you can ask me. You can send message in a school group. Now, you have to write this chapter's question answers in your literature notebook. Thank you for watching the video. Have a nice day.